Hi, my name is Dr. Becky Kuhn. I'm a physician who specializes in HIV/AIDS. Welcome to Preventing Sexual Transmission of HIV, What You Need to Know. This video will teach you information that can save your life, so please listen carefully and watch the whole video. You've probably heard of HIV/AIDS and know that it can severely affect your life and even kill you. But what can you do to reduce your risk of contracting HIV, the virus that causes AIDS? This video explains ways to reduce or eliminate your risk of contracting HIV through sexual contact, saving your life and the life of any current or future sexual partners, and if you're a woman, the lives of any future children. A longer video called Introduction to HIV and AIDS, What You Need to Know, covers more detailed information. Sexual contact is not the only way HIV is spread, but it is by far the most common way. HIV is not only present in the blood of an infected individual, but also in the semen of an infected man and in the vaginal fluids of an infected woman. When two people have sex and exchange body fluids, HIV may spread from one partner to the other. Anal sex is riskier than vaginal sex because the anal tissue is more prone to tearing during sex. HIV is also transmitted through oral sex, though it is much less common. Additionally, women who have sex with women who are HIV positive are also at risk of becoming infected through blood and vaginal secretions, though it is rare. The more sexual partners you have, the greater your risk of contracting HIV. What can you do to reduce or eliminate your risk of contracting HIV through sexual contact? Remember your ABCs. Abstain from sex before marriage. Be faithful to a single partner if you are sexually active. Use a latex condom every time you have sex, every way you have sex. Let's talk about each of these things as they're very important. Abstinence from sex until marriage to an uninfected spouse who has also abstained and being mutually faithful with your spouse after marriage is the only way to guarantee that you will not contract HIV through sexual activity. If you choose to have sex before marriage, make sure that both you and your partner know your HIV status. Do not assume that you don't have HIV and don't assume that your partner doesn't have HIV. Anyone who has been sexually active may have been exposed to HIV. A simple and quick test can tell you whether you are HIV positive. In most countries, the test is available free of charge. Remember that it can take up to 6 months after being exposed to HIV for your test to turn positive. So you only know for sure that you're HIV negative if you've tested negative for 6 months after your last possible exposure to HIV. Most importantly, if you choose to have sex before marriage, use a latex condom correctly every time you have sex, every way you have sex. If you are allergic to latex, you can use a polyurethane condom. A latex condom is not a guarantee against HIV transmission, but when used correctly, it greatly reduces the risk that one partner will infect the other. Condoms must be stored in a cool, dark place. Do not expose them to oil-based lubricants like Vaseline because they will weaken the condom. To use a condom correctly, you must put it on the hard penis before any contact between the penis and the partner's mouth, vagina, or anus. When putting the condom on the penis, leave a little extra space at the tip to hold the semen and unroll the condom down the shaft all the way. After the man ejaculates, he should hold the condom at the base of his shaft to make sure it doesn't fall off and immediately remove his penis from his partner before the penis becomes soft. Never reuse a condom. For oral sex on a woman, it is important to use a barrier like a square of latex called a dental dam. You can also cut the tip of a latex condom and cut it up the side to make a dental dam. Obviously, if you're in a culture where you do not have equal rights, you may not be able to follow the ABC guidelines. For example, women may contract HIV through rape, marital rape, or their husband's infidelity. Women may be unable to flee an abusive marriage for fear of poverty and starvation, or of losing their children. These problems are discussed in more detail in a video called Ending Gender Inequality, A Key to Stopping HIV. Because of these realities, a broader acronym was recently developed called SAVE, S-A-V-E. This means safer sexual practices, access to antiretroviral medications, voluntary counseling and testing, and empowerment and education. No matter who you are a valuable individual, and your life matters, as do the lives of those in your community. Take care of yourself and those around you. Make healthy choices that eliminate or reduce your risk of contracting HIV. Thank you for helping in the fight against HIV. This is Dr. Becky Kuhn.